That's where me and my sister Sarah live and work. The Chase, a veterinary practice in the market town of Oxley. Dad left us the house and the practice the day he married Claudie, who used to work in the local post office.
Verbally left it, there's nothing on paper.
We both think she's a gold digger, but make up your own mind. Our nurse, Matt, discovered she'd been cashing his late grandma's pension.
They think it was me! You've got to tell them!
And several other people's pensions too, as it turned out. Sending the money to Malta, where she wanted to go on honeymoon with Dad.
I thought it'd be harder to trace.
Anyway, Dad made her pay it all back, but she's still got a court case pending. My sister Sarah left Oxley when Mum died 3 years ago. She came back for Dad's wedding and met up with her old flame Adrian.
I'm asking you to marry me.
Now that he's popped the question, I'm hoping she's here to stay. She's my half-sister, really. I found out Dad wasn't my real dad. It was such a shock when I discovered my proper birth certificate. It shook my world, but I suppose they're still my family.
You wouldn't mind wafting me, would you? With one of those cat incontinence leaflets, love.
That's Margaret, our head nurse. She's menopausal and a bit dippy, but we all love her. Although she does drive our practice manager, Deborah, up the wall. But then Deborah drives us all insane with her rules and regulations.
Rules are rules, Margaret. They mean nothing if they don't apply to everyone.
I'll just grab a coffee and get started.
Oh, thank you.
Her long-suffering husband is one of our vets, Rick Johnson. They've been having a spot of trouble lately, largely caused by one of the nurses, Claire. She's a sweetheart, and it's obvious Rick has a soft spot for her.
If I wasn't a married man.
And here's our cousin, Fiona. Well, what can I say about her? Except that she was one of my closest friends and one of the practice nurses too. I really felt for her as a single mum and made sure she had a job to come back to after her little boy Theo was born. I had no idea that she was lying to us all, that she had seduced my husband Tom and her son was actually his.
She wanted to get pregnant by me.
Oh my God, she's sick.
I'd been married to Tom for 10 happy years and we have 4 children of our own. I know he was desperate for me not to find out.
It'll destroy her. It'll destroy both of us.
But like all lies, they come out in the end.
Yeah, well, if it weren't for bad luck, we'd have no luck at all.
Is that what you're wearing?
Yeah, why? What's wrong with it?
Nothing. The hearse will be here in half an hour.
I'm nearly ready.
Are you Luca or Jake?
I'm looking for a Claudie. I'm a sister.
Is that your car?
Yeah, why?
Why is it?
Pink.
Mummy! There's a lady at the door. She's really, really pretty with big...
That'll be our Paula! Paula! Oh! Oh, thanks for coming.
Hey, oh. I said I'd get you dinner.
You brought all your stuff and all.
I had my legs done yesterday, though. I did my nails myself.
Oh, I told you I'd do them for you. I've got my hair dry and everything, car.
Oh, bless. You shouldn't have bothered.
Should we make waiting room for now?
Hey, I can't believe this is where you live.
Nice, isn't it?
You'll have done well for yourself, sis.
Oh, my giddy aunt. No.
You've got to help me. I need to see if that pie's been bitten by that stupid, horrible hound.
Rosie's not horrible. She only bit her because that mongrel wouldn't leave her alone.
Pie is not a mongrel. She's got a pedigree as long as my arm. She's a border collie.
Can I just say today's not a good day?
Oh, please, you've got to help me. She's bleeding. None of the other vets can fit us in.
I'll see what they can do.
Have you seen the mess Pie's in? She's got a big lump out the back of her neck.
Well, she's called Pie. Maybe Rosie just fancied a bite.
Well, do they know we're going to a funeral?
Where are they?
Yeah, in waiting room, but I'm warning you, it's like St. Valentine's Day Massacre.
Hello, I'm Anna Williams.
What happened?
We were just walking across.
Vile dog sunk her teeth into the back of Pie's neck. I couldn't get it off her.
Frightened,
Rosie. One at a time, please.
She's not going to die, is she?
We need to go in 10 minutes. Well, we could have a quick look, couldn't we? Come straight through with me, please.
Okay, come with me.
It's just like casualty for animals in here, isn't it?
If you want to put her on the table for me.
Come on, darling.
And hold her head, please.
Good girl.
There doesn't seem to be any serious damage. Nothing too deep. And the thorax is intact, so...
I'm going straight round to the police station from here and I'm going to report
you
that...
You should see your GP first. I think that hand could do with a couple of stitches. And you need to check when you last had your tetanus.
I couldn't care less about me.
Yes, well, you should. Right, I'm going to pack this wound with some intracite gel, keep it moist. We'll stitch her later.
You'll be fine, good girl.
Don't drop your face, Lee.
It's not that I don't like Keely, it's just she doesn't come from a very nice family.
You mean they live in a council house? Like you did, Deborah?
No, I mean a brother rides a motorbike and wears an earring.
So what?
I do not want our daughter around there, Richard. I'd rather she came with us.
It won't be very nice for her.
Never seen a dead person before.
Hi. What are you up to?
Stop picking. All you see is the coffin.
Speak to me, Claire. I know it's you. Please, Claire.
I was just ringing to ask if you'd give me a reference.
A reference? What for?
I've applied for another job and I need 2 references. I don't want to ask Anna.
What have you done that for?
You know why.
Claire, please don't leave. We can sort this out, I promise you.
I can never get to talk to you.
I know. I made a mistake. I thought things were going to be different. I thought I owed it to Harriet to try
Richard,
again.
Richard, phone.
Yeah, 2 seconds.
Who are you talking to?
Hold on, will you?
Anna.
Really?
Why? What do you want to know for? Sorry, that was her. I feel like I'm going insane.
It's okay.
I should never have gone back on my word. I should have just left.
What did he say?
Who?
Rumpelstiltskin, who do you think?
I was just asking for a reference, that's all.
Yeah, right. You don't even know if you're going to apply for the job.
Are you going to get ready or what?
Yeah.
Socks!
Sorry. God forbid I might put a speck of dirt on the floor. Hello? Oh, hi, Anna. Sorry to keep you waiting. I was just outside.
I'm sorry to ring, but we've got two emergencies come in, and...
You want me to come round now?
No, but I was wondering if you could do a stitch-up for me later.
Yeah, sure, no problem.
Great. All right, see you soon.
OK, bye.
Excuse me? What do you think you're doing?
Our Claudia told me to put all my things in here.
Well, what is all this stuff?
Well, that's my spray tan gun, my wax pot and strips, my nail varnishes, acrylics, jewels and hardener. That's my fast facelift, my cellulite buster and my hair dryers and brushes.
What are they for?
What do you mean, what they're for? It's obvious, isn't it?
Your sister's been in the waiting room with beauty products.
What?
She said you told her to put them there.
What's going on? What's all this stuff, Paula?
It's from the salon.
You see that? What's he doing here?
I've got nowhere else to put it. I've been slung out of shop for not paying rent.
What?
Well, someone grasped me up and I had to pay all this money to stupid VAT people or I would have got done and I didn't have enough to pay my rent. So, Adolf put all my stuff in backyard, chains of chuffing locks.
Oh, wow, look at all they.
Hey, them's nail jewels, don't lose them. It's only for a couple of days, just till I get myself sorted out.
Well, you definitely can't leave all this here.
No, absolutely not.
I can't leave it outside during my car. It might get nicked.
Daisy, grab some and follow me.
Hang on a minute. You can't just go making decisions like that.
Who says?
I do. We do.
Well, I'm a sister, and where else is she going to put them?
Come on.
Anna.
What? What do you want me to say?
This is ridiculous. This is our house.
There's two black horses and a carriage coming in the drive.
About wearing a hat. But I've only got my pink one. And I thought it'd look a bit odd.
I don't think it matters.
I never thought I'd see this day.
Oh, don't start again, you'll set me off.
Oh.
Think Fiona will show up?
Oh, no way, she wouldn't dare.
Well, Shirley's here. She's probably got no one to look after Theo.
Who's that with her?
I'm not sure. Oh, I think it might be a sister from Liverpool.
So are we going back to the house or not?
I don't know. It depends.
Just because our Fiona's fallen out with them doesn't mean to say we have to. I mean, the family. I haven't seen the girls and the children since our Imogen's funeral.
If you want to go back, then go. I'm just not sure I'd be welcome. Oh, Lord. What the hell's he doing here?
Mary? Shirley? Oh, I see. Still not talking to me. Only been 26 years. So, how's life treating you, Mary?
You've gone grey and lost your looks.
Nice to see you too.
What do you want?
I had some business in the area. I have a couple of pubs to look at, so I thought I'd call in on Fiona and there was nobody in, so... She's not coming to the funeral.
She's had a fallout with the family. Takes after her old man.
Looks like they're here.
They always
always have to make a show.
Nice to be alive, don't you think?
Not when your husband tells you a pack of lies.
I told you, I made a mistake. I got mixed up. I said Anna and I meant Sarah. It's no big deal. You just can't help yourself, can you, Deborah?
I'm trying my best, Richard.
Really?
Sarah.
Oh, guess what? It's a pantomime.
Today we gather to celebrate a full life well lived. Everybody who knew George Williams only had good things to say about him.
Which one?
He was a genuinely caring and compassionate man. Not only was he a brilliant vet and an exceptional father and grandfather, he was also a thoroughly decent and caring man.
My marriage is over.
What? Don't be ridiculous, for heaven's sake.
Oh, I can't do this right now. Can you just go back outside?
Now, sweetheart, don't push me away. Please.
Dad, will you just leave it?
The police are taking Auntie Claudia away and she's crying.
He'll be sadly missed by his two daughters, Anna and Sarah. He was a devoted husband for 32 years to his beloved wife, Imogen. And I know after she died, many of you thought he'd never find love again, but he was blessed in the last few months of his life when he met and married Claudie. Sadly, their life together was to be cut short.
Claudie!
Don't leave me on me own!
Don't worry, love. I'm going straight down there, honey bunch. Check that Anna's all right, will you? I've got to go to the police station.
We'll take the Land Rover. The keys are in the ignition.
Stand back, please.
Oh. He just came straight up. Oh. I couldn't miss him.
I know. Oh, Dad!
Your heart can be empty because you can't see him. Or you can be full of the love that you shared. You can turn your back on tomorrow and live for yesterday. Or you can be happy for tomorrow because of yesterday.
You can shed tears that he's
gone. It's all my fault!
Or you can...
No, it wasn't. Don't say that.
Do you want me to carry on?
You all right?
Yeah. I was trying not to break down. I thought I could do...
It's all right. You have a good cry.
Yeah, your mascara's waterproof. You can bawl your eyes out if you want.
He's with her now. Where am I going to go?
Or you can smile because he lived. You can close your eyes and pray that he will come back.
Once. It happened once.
When I was in hospital, after just giving birth to Jake.
Tell me what you want me to do and I'll do it. I love you. And I'll always love you. But I understand if you want me to leave.
You fathered a child with my cousin. You've lied to me for the last 3 years. What do you think I want you to do, Tom?
That he is gone. Or you can cherish his memory and let it live on. You can cry and close your mind, be empty and turn your back. Or you could do what he would want. Smile, open your eyes, love, and go on. And that's why I'm wearing this today. For my Georgie. He loved me in this. He said I didn't suit black. He said said it drained all the colour out of my cheeks.
That's right. Black's morbid.
Widow Twankey deserves an Oscar.
In his presence is the fullness of joy. And at his right hand, there is pleasure forevermore. Amen. Amen.
You're not welcome here.
I've known your father for 12 years. I just wanted to pay my respect.
Clearly you have no respect for my father, or you wouldn't have betrayed his daughter and grandchildren. Come on.
We need to talk, Anna.
I've got nothing to say to you.
Is Daddy coming home?
See you later, Daddy.
I'm terribly sorry, Sarah. He was the nicest man, and I don't know what to say. Words escape me.
Thank you, William. Are you coming back to the house?
No, I'm with my brother, so...
Oh, Sebastian can come.
Well, if you're absolutely sure.
Yes, of course.
Excuse me. Do you want to go back in the funeral car with me?
No, I'm going to go back with my sister. You don't mind, do you?
No, of course not.
Last time I saw you, you were 8 years old.
Oh, I'm sorry, I don't think...
Your Uncle Frank...
Oh, right. I thought you were a lot taller with dark hair.
Oh, well, maybe that's because you were 4 foot nothing and you used to look up to me.
Maybe it's just because you've got old and shrunk.
I hope you don't mind me turning up like this, but I was in the area and he was my brother-in-law.
Of course not. I hope you all come back to the house.
For heaven's sakes, I wish I'd never wronged you now. Fancy turning up at the funeral?
I've got every right to be here. Anyway, no one knows. Not even Shirley knows.
If you cause trouble, if you open your mouth...
Why do you always think the worst of me, Mary?
Because you never let me down. That's why, Frank.
Sebastian Montgomery's back on the scene.
Yeah, well, he'll run out of money, won't he? He'll be running away from some woman. What people see him.
He's good looking, he's funny.
What did Tom say to you?
Oh, just that he wanted to pay his respects. Is he well done?
No idea. You know he's living above the Black Bull, don't you?
Who told you that?
Adrian, I bumped into him.
How much longer are they going to be?
5 minutes.
Oh, Paula hadn't had any breakfast. Told you we should have done sandwiches. Job, we've got that extra wine. We've already gone through 4 bottles.
Well, you don't have to fill people's glasses up right to the top.
Yeah, well, it saves me topping them up again. And if it hadn't been for our Paula, I couldn't have managed.
Just put the bottles on the side and let people help themselves.
They'll be throwing it down the next, then.
No, they won't. This is Oxley, not the Hawkswood Estate. The sooner that woman and her sister are out of our lives, the better.
Sarah, Dad loved her.
I know he did.
I just can't help thinking what she said at the graveside was right.
If she hadn't begged him to go to the police station with her, then he would. He'd still be alive. He'd still be here.
Come on. It's all right.
It's not all right. It's never going to be all right, is it? I never even said goodbye to him.
No, neither did I. In fact, when he came into the kitchen to see if I was all right, I shouted at him. I told him to go away and leave me alone.
I told him to get in the Land Rover.
So if it hadn't been the Land Rover, it'd have been his car?
No. No. Because his car was blocked in.
Stop it. He was distracted. You know what a terrible driver he was?
I know. I should have driven him.
Look, it was nobody's fault. It was an accident. He knew how much we loved him.
Mine have all gone.
Right, well, you can put the keys out.
He gave the girls the house and practised in front of everyone. I mean, we were all there. If it comes to it, we can vouch for that, can't we?
Yeah, that's true.
Claire, can I have a quick word?
Yeah, thanks. Of course.
Thank you.
Trouble brewing?
Yeah, my money's on Deborah.
We got a couple of dogs in this morning. They've been scrapping. I promised Anna I'd check them over and do the stitch-up on the border collie. Now, I've had a look at her. She's pretty stable, but...
You know she's looking at us.
I don't care. We're talking work. I want you to assist.
No, Rick, I can't.
Yes, you can. and not having people telling me who I can and can't work with. It's just my day off, they've asked me to work, and I choose who I want to assist, right? And we'll get a chance to talk.
You'll have to tell her then.
I will.
Suppose that was about the reference again.
What reference?
He's stitching a dog and he's asked me to assist, that's all.
Yeah?
She won't like that.
Go, girl.
I was his nurse for 4 years, Margaret.
And look what happened.
Nothing happened. Nothing at all, Margaret.
All right, you don't have to get all uppity with me. I was just saying. Oh, that's it. You've started me off now. Oh, I'm dripping wet.
Sorry.
Oh.
It's cool fun, though, don't you think?
Our Shelley brought it me back from Spain. My batteries kept running out on me other one, so I've gone manual.
I'd forgotten what a big house this is. The food's lovely. You've done him proud.
Thank you. I'm just pleased you managed to make it.
I'm sorry to hear about you and Tom splitting up. I always liked him.
Yeah, well, so did I.
It's going to be hard with four kids.
I know.
Well, if ever you need a break, you can bring them over to see me.
Actually, I was going to come and see you a couple of months back. I found my birth certificate.
Your mother never wanted anyone to tell. She made
it's
us all
right.
Promise.
I'm over it now. I was curious, that's all. Did you know who my real father was?
No, none of us did. She wouldn't tell a soul.
Auntie Shirley said she was seeing someone from the Navy.
That's right, maybe it was him, but we'll never know. Excuse me a minute, love, I've just remembered something.
I think we should ask for speed bumps. People travel far too fast down that road. I mean, we're a market town.
Sorry to interrupt. I'm just going through the surgery now, so...
I'll ask Matt if he can come.
Well, I've already asked Claire.
OK, fine. Can Harriet watch? I think she's a bit bored.
I'm not sure she'll, like... If she wants it.
Harriet.
Do you think she'll put some more food out?
No, there's some left. I'll tell you what I do think, though. I think we should give Claudia to the end of the week and then tell her to move out.
Who's going to tell her?
I will.
Maybe we should talk to the solicitor first.
What for? We both know what Dad really wanted. He said it loud and clear on his wedding day. Even had the paperwork drawn up.
Yeah, I know. Let's just get this over and done with.
I want her out of here. Look at her. She's not even upset about Dad.
Yeah, well, she was at the funeral.
That's the first time I've seen her cry over him.
Maybe she's still in shock.
Oh, come on. He was just a meal ticket to her. All Claudia saw was money. We both know that.
Mind if you keep these in your fridge?
No, what for?
It's just for the pasta sale by day.
I said for how long?
It's only two little pots.
Well, your sister's going to be moving out at the end of the week.
Really? That's not what she was telling me. She said she's really settled here and I don't blame her. It's a cool house and it's like a blooming mansion. Do you want some more vino?
No, thanks. I've had enough.
I'm going to talk to Peter Clancy. We've got to get this sorted out. It's doing my head in.
So it was my job to clip the hair away and prepare the site for stitching or for the operation.
Right. Have you ever seen Matt playing in his band?
Yeah, lots of times.
He said he'd take me backstage.
Did he? Well, you're lucky.
Harriet, can you go and get some more swabs, darling? They're in the...
I know where they are.
And the staple gun.
I think that should be by the side of the autoclave. No, please, don't.
What if someone comes in?
I don't care anymore. George went just like that. One minute he was here, the next he was gone. It just takes one thing to happen.
Don't say that.
At the funeral, I kept looking across at you. I could see how upset you were. I just wanted to come over to you and put my arms around you. I swear to God, I nearly did.
I wanted you to.
I don't know what stopped me. All I kept thinking was, why am I stood here with Deborah and I should be over there with you?
If you're just saying this because I asked you for a reference this morning...
No, it's got nothing to do with the reference.
Good. Because there isn't any job. Not yet, anyway. I haven't applied.
Well, don't.
I rang you this morning because I just wanted to hear your voice.
I was a coward. I should have just stuck to what I said I was going to do.
But you didn't. You went back because of Harriet.
I don't want to die thinking I wasn't man enough to be with the woman I love.
can see he must have been very handsome in his time. I'm presuming it was another woman.
How did you guess?
Never mind, you've got Fiona. She must be a comfort to you. I know the girls have fallen out with her, but George was still her uncle and very fond of her, as far as I know.
There you are. I've been looking for you.
Excuse me. We've got a dog in surgery. I'm just going to check everything's all right.
But you might have warned me, Anna, knew George wasn't a real father.
I'm sorry, I forgot. What did she say to you?
She asked me if I knew who it was.
She asked me to. I had to tell her the truth that I didn't know. What did you say?
Same. But I had no idea.
Let's leave her on some oxygen for a bit while she wakes up. Ah, Deborah, nice of you to join us. Could you make an invoice out for a Jack Fallon? A full exam, antibiotics, 30-minute surgical time, anaesthetic, stitching and hospitalisation. Oh, and there's an address and telephone number in the book. If you could ring him and let him know, he can pick him up in about an hour.
I'm not supposed to be working.
No, neither are we. As soon as she comes to, pop her in the kennel. I'm just going to go check on the German Shepherd.
She's had 14 stitches.
Really? Will you make sure you leave the place as you found it?
I always do. It's a border collie called Pie.
Mum's cross again about something. She'll give Dad a hard time on the way home.
It's just a pity he never actually signed the house over to
him. But you know he meant to. He told you. So, when do you think it'll all be sorted? Only we need to know where we stand.
Of course. No problem. I'll hang on and we'll do it this evening.
Thanks, Peter.
Hello, stranger.
Hi.
Are you avoiding me or am I just being paranoid?
Being paranoid? Come on, I've got a mingle, haven't I? There's family here that I hardly even know.
Sarah.
What?
I know today is not a great day. I asked you a question over a week ago and you still haven't given me an answer yet.
Well, a lot's happened this week, Adrian. I haven't been able to think about anything else except keeping this family together and supporting Anna.
Would you really have to think about it that much?
No, it's the timing, that's all. Anyway, you know what the answer is.
No, I don't.
Of course I want to marry her.
That was just fantastic. Come on. It's about time this family had some good news.
No.
Excuse me, everyone. Can I just have a few words, please? Look, it's been a pretty devastating week for the Williams family. But I thought you might like to know that the last conversation I had with George was to ask for his daughter's hand in marriage. Fortunately, he said yes. Aww. Actually, he said if we wanted to elope, he'd buy us a ladder. But seriously, though, he was delighted. So I popped the question to Sarah. Unfortunately for me, she just said yes.
Does that mean she'll believe it? Expect's always got a big farmhouse. Nice, though, isn't it? George would be dead chuffed.
Thank you.
Thank you, William. Thank you. Thank you.
Why didn't you tell me you'd spoken to Dad?
I wanted you to make up your own mind.
I knew you two would end up together. Welcome to the family.
Thanks.
I know you're going to make each other really happy.
Are you all right?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm fine, honestly.
And to think she could have had me.
Never mind, sweetheart. Your time will come. Yeah.
Well, congratulations to both of you.
Thank you. Well done.
Cheers, sir. So is it about time you got yourself hitched?
Well, if I could find anyone to have me, I would.
Oh, yeah, don't give me that.
It's true, they've all got wives to me.
Well, the clever ones have, yeah.
Well, they're the only ones I find interesting, and I'm afraid the charms just don't seem to work anymore.
Hmm. But anyway, I thought you'd have one of those sugar babes on your arm by now.
Only. I'm merely the producer on the label. I walk around pretending that I know what's going on and generally telling everybody how fantastic it's all sounding.
Great news about your sister.
Yeah, fantastic. I just can't help thinking that I wish my dad was here to enjoy it with us, that's all.
Oh, I'm sorry. I shouldn't.
No, it's fine, honestly. He always wanted Sarah to get married. They were really close. She was his... Excuse me.
Anna.
Yes.
I don't know what you and Fiona fell out over, but life's too short.
Don't get involved, Uncle Frank. It really is none of your business.
Well, of course it's my business. She's my daughter.
You know nothing about it. Perhaps if you'd have been a better father to Fiona, none of this would have happened.
None of what?
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have said that. Excuse me.
Is your mother in, sweetheart?
Are you coming to take Auntie Claudia to prison?
No. But if you could just tell her it's about Rosie Armstrong.
Right, come in. Mum, there's... Are you crying about Dad or Grandad?
Both.
But I think Dad wants to come back home.
No, sweetheart, it's just... Things are a bit complicated at the minute. Nothing for you to worry about, though.
But it is. I miss him and Grandad.
Come here. I miss them too.
Forgive me, Uncle George.
It's a very difficult day for the family.
I appreciate that.
But I'll just go and see if I can find my husband.
Many thanks.
So who's going to inherit, then?
Not the daughters, I expect.
You know, the old boy just got himself hitched, didn't he?
The girls will soon see her off.
Where's your father?
I don't know.
Shouldn't Claire be doing that?
She's busy.
Busy doing what?
I don't know.
We all do stupid things when we're young. Live to regret it. You just hope people have it in their heart to forgive and move on.
Well, clearly Auntie Shirley's never going to forgive you, is she?
I know, and it's a pity. Because Fiona and Theo are the ones who really suffer.
Did you end up marrying the woman you left Auntie Shirley for?
No. Didn't work out. She was married and decided at the last minute to stay with her family.
So you got what was coming to you then?
Could say that.
Do anything.
No, it's me. I'm doing all the doing. I want you. I want to be with you. And I don't care who knows.
My role.
I'm sorry, but your dog is not fit to be let loose.
Really,
she's a menace to society.
I won't be a minute.
I could come back later.
Pipe You're not has been hear savaged. The last of this.
I'm gonna tell her tonight.
Tell her what?
That I'm leaving. That I made a mistake when I said I'd try again. She can't change. She knows she can't. It's torture for me. And it's not fair on Harriet having to deal with all that tension. Come here.
Listen, it's not my place to do the forgiving, Uncle Frank. I suggest you talk to Fiona and get her to tell you why there's a rift in the family.
I will.
Excuse me, have you seen Richard?
He's in surgery, isn't he?
The dog owners and the police have arrived.
What, now? Today?
Excuse me.
When am I going to see you?
I don't know.
We could get a guest house or something. We could be together tonight.
No, it's not fair. You've got to tell her first.
But I want to be with you. I want to sleep next nasty. Oh, I wake up in the morning and just look at your face.
Mom? What are you doing?
It's Harriet.
I'm still looking for your father.
Maybe he's inside?
You're a nice, sturdy girl, aren't you? Nothing wrong here.
Oh, I didn't know you were. Mum was just looking for you.
Oh, when was that?
Just now. She was still outside. I thought she checked in here.
No, I don't think so. Did you see Deborah Clare?
No.
What did she want?
Don't know. There was a policeman at the door and the dog owners.
She must have seen us. What are we going to do?
She can't have done it. She'd have been straight in here. We've just got to act normal, like nothing's happened, all right?
My partner is absolutely...
In your professional veterinary capacity, would you say Rosie Armstrong was a dangerous dog?
Well, I've treated her several times before and she's never gone for me or tried to bite me. She can be a bit nervous sometimes.
Because she was badly treated when she was a pup. That's
why. Why don't you take a look at my dog's neck and you can decide for yourself?
Can we just have one at a time, please, and let the vet speak? Sorry, Miss Williams, but if we can just clear this up, we can get out of your hair.
OK, well, it is rather a deep bite, but then German Shepherds do have a very strong jaw. It looks as if Rosie might have been trying to fend off the Border Collie to begin with, judging by the scratch marks on her face and the bites on her legs.
So what you're saying is you think it's six of one and half a dozen of the other?
In a nutshell, only Rosie's the stronger dog.
That's utter rubbish. I'm not having this. I'm going to see my solicitor. That dog needs putting down.
Will you stop saying that? God, my son and his wife have moved to Kent. I haven't seen the grandchildren in months. If it wasn't for Rosie, my life wouldn't be worth living.
Bringing a dog prosecution is a very long drawn out job.
She was trying to defend herself.
And it'll cost you a fortune.
Listen, it's just a suggestion. But how about if Mrs. Armstrong promises to keep Rosie on a lead from now on and contribute something towards the vet bill?
I'm very happy to do that, my dear. I always do keep her on a lead, but this is the third one she's chewed up. I'm sorry she bit Pye, and I'm very sorry she bit your hand.
I'll see you in the morning. Oh, thank you for coming, Deborah. We really do appreciate it. Where's Rick? He's still sorting the dogs out, but I've got a bit of a migraine starting, so I think I'd better head home.
Oh, well, I hope it passes.
So, there's going to be another wedding.
What is it that Adrian's got that I haven't? A farm. It's a farm.
Yeah, that's what it is, Matt, a farm.
Oh, looks good, Kill. You'd be dead with a concrete block around your neck.
Ah, take no notice. Look, that woman needs to get a life.
I'm fine.
Here we go. Four paws, two eyes and a tail, all accounted for.
How's Pye?
She's fine. She's just finishing off a drip, then you can take her home. But we'll need to see her again in 10 days for her stitches out, all right?
Oh, this is the culprit, is it?
Yeah.
Who's that naughty girl? Hey, are you going to say sorry? You'll never do it again. Look, I'm really okay about paying your vet bill.
I can't let you pay it all. I mean, Pa was jumping up and...
How about half?
That's fine.
If you're sure.
Do you want me to stay here for a bit? I'd love nothing better, but we haven't got any room, sweetheart. Right. It's just that...
Just that what?
I've got nowhere to live. What's up with your flat? It's above shop, isn't it? Rent was all in, so I'm homeless.
Oh, bloody hell, Paula.
Excuse me, can I buy you a glass? Yeah, sure. You'll have to bunk in with me for a bit. She just took my wine.
I think she thought James was Theo's dad, like we all did.
Excuse me. Sorry, it just slipped out of my hand.
You did that on purpose?
Yes, I did. I want you to wipe that smug, self-satisfied grin off your face. If there's any damage, I'll pay for the cleaning. Where's Harriet? I'm taking a car. Shall I get you top?
Claire, I'm so sorry. You're all right.
Do you want to go?
She is off her trolley.
Claire. Claire, hang on a minute.
Peter wants to go through some legal stuff with us later. Does he have to? I don't feel up to it.
Well, we need to know where we stand.
It's quite clear where I stand.
Really?
I'm his wife. I love him to bits. And I'm heartbroken.
Oh, she is and all. It's a bloody good job I made to look after her, that's all I can say.
You know, you'd look great with big curly hair.
My hair is big and curly.
Ooh, get you.
Claire. No, I can't do this. No, I'm sorry. I feel like some sort of evil homewrecker.
No, don't Stephen say that. You're the only thing that's keeping me together. Please, it's my fault. No, that's all my fault. I'll sort it out.
I just can't do this.
Don't finish
this.
Please, please.
I was in the area, so I went to George's funeral.
I just thought that you'd come here and see what a mess I've made in my life.
Deborah, I need to talk to you. Deborah.
Mum doesn't want to talk to you.
Take the chain off, Harriet.
Mum says...
It's all right. You go do your homework.
Deborah, I can't do this.
I've ironed all your shirts and put your shoes in shoe bags. I haven't packed your suits in case they got creased.
Thank you.
All your CDs are in that box. I've kept them in alphabetical order. I'll drop your mail off at work, but I'd appreciate it if you had it redirected.
Of course, yes.
And, I think that's it.
I'm really sorry.
Save your breath, Richard. Could I have the house keys, please? Thank you. I've ordered a taxi. He'll be here in a minute. And I'm going to help Harriet with her homework.
Is that it?
Is that what?
You don't have anything else to say?
Not really, no. Except you're not the man I thought you were. You disappoint me. Right, come on, kids. Teeth clean, pyjamas on. Now. Come on. Have a bath in the morning.
But Dad always puts us to
bed. Yes, well, Daddy's not here, is he? Come on. I'll read you a bedtime story in a minute, OK?
I'll take that.
Well, you'll have to stay here as well. How long is it going to take, Peter?
Not long.
I'll take him up if you like.
Yeah!
Come on, then. Show you, Mum.
She's good with kids, is our Paula. She used to work as a nanny before she got done for drugs. Right then, let's see what you've got to say.
Well, your late mother and father did make a will.
And late husband.
Sorry, yes. They made a will in 1987, leaving the house, practice, all household contents, including the motor vehicles and chattel, to the surviving partner. And upon the death of the surviving partner, the estate was to be divided equally between their two daughters, Anna and Sarah. However, that will was revoked in 2006 when your father remarried, and so is no longer valid.
But he wanted to leave the house and practice to us. He gave it to us on his wedding day.
Yes, I'm aware of that, but unfortunately, we have nothing in writing.
But he said it in front of everybody. You were there. He didn't sign nothing, though, did he? And he told me he was having second thoughts. That's why I wanted clauses put in.
That's not true. You put doubts in his head.
Don't you call me a liar, madam. Who the hell do you think you are?
If I could just explain...
I'm my father's daughter, that's who, madam. And my family have lived in this house for over 30 years. I was born in the front bedroom.
Our parents built this practice from nothing. My mother was a receptionist and a nurse. My father worked day and night.
Don't get on your eye, horse, love. You weren't even your real dad.
How dare you speak to my sister like that? You are a truly vile person. I wish to God he'd never met you.
Yeah, go on. Say what you've always wanted to say.
Do you know what? My father would still be alive if it wasn't for you.
You cow! I'll kill you!
Get off
there! No need for this, please!
I loved your father and you bloody well know that! I'm grieving the man I worship, the man I live for.
He was our way.
Father?
You were married for 2 minutes.
I've known him for years. I knew him when your mother was alive.
What? I hope you're not suggesting what I think you are.
He used to come in the post office once a week. He always had a little twinkle with me. I could have had your dad like that, but I wouldn't. Not while he was married. How dare you? He worshipped our mother!
Sorry, Peter, but I can't listen to any more of this. I'm going to go sort out the kids.
In hindsight, I don't think today was the right time.
There's never going to be a right time for them, is there? Because they just think they should have the lot and I should disappear into a big hole. Well, tough. Because I'm going nowhere. And neither is my sister. We both belong here.
The moon is round, has two eyes, a nose, and a big mouth. Just your hands and you're finished. There we go.
Are you going to look after us?
What? I don't know, love. Could do.
Are you going to live in our house?
Would you like that? Well, you just tell your mummy that, and who knows?
Tell mummy what?
When you lose your teeth. Tooth Fairy gives you £2.
Where's Daisy and Luca?
Getting ready for bed. Right. Come on, Jake, let's get your gym jams on.
Anna! I'm sorry you had to witness that.
No, it's perfectly understandable.
That will not really, but...
It's a very trying time for the family, and these situations are never easy. I'll drop you a line spelling out all the options, then we'll talk.
Thanks, Peter.
And, really sorry about your dad. He was a dear friend and a lovely man. Bye.
Bye. Sergeant Meadows is downstairs. He wants a word with us both.
What about?
No idea.
You'll meet someone else, you know.
I don't want to meet anybody else. George was the love of my life.
Never mind. Got me here now. You don't still snore, do you?
George liked my snoring. Said it lulled him off to sleep. Who is it?
The police want to see you.
But I haven't done anything wrong.
I've tried to manage as best as I could, you know, but it's hard bringing up a kid on your own. I've never asked Tom for money, though.
You should have come to me if you needed money.
Why would I come to you? You never phoned me. I've seen you, like, 3 or 4 times since you left.
Just because I'm not in touch, it doesn't mean that I don't think about you. You could always ring me.
Oh, Mum wouldn't like that. She doesn't even like me talking about you.
I know. And she has to move on. It all happened such a long time ago. I've been married and divorced and managed 3 pubs since I left your mother.
You left her for a sister, though, Dad. She's never going to get over that.
I know it was a terrible thing. You can't choose who you fall in love with.
You're right.
I was a young man. I'd known her a long time. I knew her even before I met your mother. In fact, it was your auntie Imogen that introduced us.
Anyway, that's why the family's fallen out with me and it's why I've lost my job.
I don't understand why you had to tell Anna. Wanted you being better just...
I didn't want to tell her, Dad. Neither did Tom. Yeah, she'd been through enough. She found out Uncle George wasn't her real father. She was devastated. I would have never said anything to her. I would have taken it to my grave. God knows I would, but... It was Sarah that told her. Oh, she's hated me ever since we were kids.
Why would she hate you?
Because she's jealous of me and Anna, how close we were.
If you're close, why did you do that to her?
Just happened. We'd had a few drinks. I knew Tom liked me. He was always trying to be alone with me. I'm not proud of what I did. Hannah. She's... been like a sister to me.
She is a sister to you, Fiona.
What do you mean?
I mean... I'm Anna's real father.
So this isn't about the dogs, then?
No, I think that sorted itself out.
And it's not about Claudie and the pension books?
No, we're just waiting for a court hearing date for that. Look, I'm really sorry about this. It'll all become clear in a minute.
Is your stepmother coming?
She's not our stepmother anymore.
It's Mrs. Williams.
Well, do you think she'll be joining us?
I think she was waiting for her nails to dry or something. I'll give her a shout.
I'll just come in. Right, what's all this about?
Mrs. Williams. This is Detective Inspector Weston from
London.
Pleased to meet you.
You know, we took the Land Rover.
It's all right, Sergeant Meadows. When there's been a fatality involving motor vehicles, we have to do a thorough investigation. We just had the accident report back. And unfortunately, I have to report that on the car your father was travelling in...
The Land Rover?
There is evidence to suggest that the brakes had been tampered with.
What? Tampered with?
What's that supposed to mean?
It means that we have reasons to believe your father's death was not an accident.
Well, don't look at me.
This veterinary practice is being taken over by aging Barbies looking for manicures and tans and God knows what else the mind boggles.
What do you think Dad'd make of you setting up a beauty clinic in the middle of his practice?
You and your sister don't like how I'm running things. You can just sod off any time you like.
So are you going to the ball tonight?
Are you asking?
Look who the last people in the Land Rover were. Me and Fiona.
I don't care how much you hate my family. It's nothing compared to how much I hate you.
Fantastic!
Are we dancing?
I don't think so. Look who's here.
You're a heartless, gold-digging pig.
That's what you think of me, then. Give me my share of this house in cash.
The chase continues next Sunday at the later time of 8:30. Next tonight here on BBC One, a beautiful new series, David Dimbleby travels the country to explore how we built Britain.